Hey, this is a bonus video for a two-part video exercise where we are making a circle mesh without using Blender's built-in circle mesh operator. In part two, I mentioned that we can make this code right here look more elegant, and this is exactly what we'll be doing in this video. If you're just joining us, I'll provide a link in the description where you can get a copy of this code. You just copy that code, go into the scripting workspace, hit new, and then paste that code in, and you'll be all set. Let me first remove the exercise code we did in the final video by just removing this part, clearing the scene by hitting AX and then delete, and then rerunning the script. All right, you should get a circle mesh, and we'll start from that. Let's summarize the problem and then look at the solution. So I don't like this part right here where we're outside of the loop and having to append this new edge. And we have to go from not just like the vert count, we have to minus one, like go from 0 to 30, right? So we have a vert count of 32. And the range goes from 0 to -1, whatever this is. So this would be from 0 to 31, and this is from 0 to 30. So if I comment this part out and then just delete everything and run the script again, you can see that the mesh is not fully connected, right? We have this edge right here that is missing. This is exactly what we're doing with this line. To fix that, let's actually look at exactly what's happening, like what are these indices here. So we're creating edges from indices of this list. So this is a list of verts, right? Let's print that out. I'm going to create a new loop. I'm going to use vert count in the range, and let's just paste that. So I'm gonna use I and then draw an arrow, and then use I to access. So I'm accessing, I'm through looping through all the elements of this vert coordinates list. Let's do just that. To see the results, I need to open the system console. Here it is. Again, on Mac and Mac and Linux, you'll need to go through a separate video to get this working, unfortunately. But on Windows, it's straightforward. It's just under a menu. All right. So this is what we're looking at right here. So we have this arrow, and we're accessing the zeroth element of this list, and that's what that is. And then we're going all the way to 31 and printing out the contents, right? This is exactly why we need to stop at vert minus one, because remember, we're calculating I plus one. So when this is 31, I plus 1 is 32, and then we're going to try to access, or Blender's going to, when creating an edge, it's going to try to access the 32nd element of this list. Let's do just that and see what happens. So I'm going to go outside of this loop, and I'm going to, you know what, I'm just going to print like so. So I'm going to say, like, let's go I equals 32, right? So, and let's run script, right? It's the script fails. And let's see, let's look at the error. And as you can see, a list index out of range, line 48. So this line right here, let's look at that. So yeah, this is exactly the line where we're trying to access something that's outside of the list. And that's why we're doing this, you know, minus one, and then having to use append outside of the this for loop. let's take a look at how we can solve this. And we're gonna be solving this by using the remainder. Let's go into the interactive Python console and look at some math. So let's say that I wanna divide 13 by 5 and we get 2.6. Thing is that when I do a remainder, this operation is called a modulo operation in most programming languages. So we get this 3. So just to kind of refresh what that is if we take this 2, so we're going to take the 2, multiply that by 5, and we're going to get 10, right? Then I'm going to use that and then plus this 3 that we got here. So, and we get 13. So we're kind of representing division with whole numbers. Actually, in Python, there's a nice built-in function called divmod. And it returns a tuple that has this like division with two slashes and then the modulo. Like, let me quickly show you what the two like slashes mean. So again, we're going 13 and we're running 13 divided by 5. That's 2.6. And if we do double, it just drops everything after the decimal point. So it's just going to be 2. So let's do the div mod with these two values. So div mod and 13 and comma 5. Right. So we get the 2 and the 3. Remember that we got right here. So that's the 3 and that's the 2. All right. So one of the properties of the modulo is the result of the modulo is going to be always less than the divisor, so the number on the right. Let's take a look. So if I do 0 mod 5, I get 0, 1, just watch. So that's just, it's going to equal itself, right? So everything's less than 5. Then when I get to 5, I'm going to go start over with the 0. So then we get 6 is going to be 1, 7, 2, 8 is 3, 9 is 4, right? And then guess what 10 is going to be? Yep, 0. Right, so with that, you can start using this property and kind of think of it as maybe analogy could be it's like a clock, right? And it goes around from 0 to minus 1, whatever the divisor is, right? So we can use that and kind of go back around. And this is what we're going to be doing here. So in this case, we're going to be using the full range from 0 to 31. Even though this is going to be 32, I'm going to do a modulo here. So mod and then the vert count. So we don't want to pass the vert count because if we do, it's going to result in an exception. I'm going to not do this for now, and I'm just going to show you and run it. Oops, yeah, so we need to remove this because that's bad. And then we run the script again, and let's take a look. And as you can see, instead of going from 31 to 32, so this part right here, we're using modulo to loop back around to 0. So we're gonna be able to connect the last and the first vert. So let's uncomment this and rerun the script. And as you can see, now we have everything connected as we wanted to. And again, if you're not feeling comfortable with this type of code, It's totally fine to keep it as it was before. The most important thing when you're starting out is to keep things readable and understandable for you when you come back in a week, in a month, in a year, right? So just know that you could use the modulo in this way, and I hope you learned that. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to give this video a like, and thank you for watching.